Students, I hope you are doing fine. I am Professor Masood Fuzail. Today we are going to discuss phylum Nematoda. Nematoda are animals which belongs to Aeschylomyces, which are pseudocoelomate animals belonging to kingdom Animalia. If we look at the literal meaning of the nematodes, nemato mean thread, and their common name is thread worms because these animals are worm-like and they are very thin like threads, so that is why these are known as thread worms, and which are also commonly called as roundworms. So this phylum is composed of different videos, different lectures, which can be divided into 3 or 4 lectures, but today we are going to discuss external and internal characteristics of roundworms or nematodes. So first of all, I am going to emphasize on some important characteristics of this phylum. So let's discuss some important characteristics of this phylum. Number one, the phylum animals of the phylum Nematoda, these are usually triploblastic. As you know that triploblastic are those animals which has 3 body layers, ectoderm, endoderm and mesoderm. These animals have bilateral symmetry. As you know that they are elongated, long body shape, so that is why these animals have bilateral symmetry. As you know that bilateral symmetry is that symmetry in which the animal can be divided into 2 equal halves in only one plane. These animals are vermiform. It means that their body is long, elongated, cylinder, and in the form of a worm. So that is why they are known as vermiform body. These animals are usually unsegmented. They do not have segmented body. These animals are also called pseudocoelomates. As you know that pseudocoelomates are those animals which do not have true body cavity or coelom in their body. So that is why these animals are known as pseudocoelomates. Usually cuticle is present. Cuticle is a protective layer around their epidermis, just like our nails, which helps to protect the body of the animals from the digestive enzyme of the host where they thrive. They also do molting or ecdysis during the juvenile stage. Usually they have hydrostatic skeleton as they do not contain bones, so that is why they have a fluid present inside the pseudocoelom of the body cavity, which act as a skeleton and provide mechanical support to the animals. So that is why they have hydrostatic skeleton. They usually move by undulating wave movement, and they do not have circular muscle in their body, which we will discuss later in this lecture. Now let's move on to the internal and external structure of the animal. So I have made a diagram for you. This is a worm-like body of a nematode. This is the anterior end of the body and this is the posterior end of the body. So first of all, we are going to discuss the outermost layer of the body, which is known as cuticle. So I have taken a small piece of cuticle from the surface of the animal and enlarged it with help of a microscope. So this is the portion of a cuticle. Their cuticle is composed of lipid and some other material which is made up of chitin. The outermost layer of the cuticle is lipid layer, which as you can see in the red area. This is the outermost layer of the cuticle. Just beneath the outermost lipid layer, there is a cortex. The cortex can be divided into 2 layers, which is outer layer and inner layers. So these 2 layers just beneath the lipid layer are the cortex. And just beneath the cortex, there is a matrix layer, which is the main layer of the cuticle. And beneath the matrix layer, there is a basal layer, which is the innermost layer of the cuticle. And just under the basal layer, there is a membrane, which is also known as basal lamina, which separates the cuticle from the epidermis of the animal. So this layer of the cuticle, sometimes is smooth, while sometimes it contains bristles, spines, bumps, or some other kind of surface area. And this cuticle helps to protect the animal from the digestive enzymes and some other dangers present in the atmosphere. If we look at the external structure of the body, so if we look at on this side there, this is the anterior side of the body. Just anterior to the body, there are small bumps present on the anterior surface, which are known as lips. Lips are very sensitive and they help the animal to locate their location. They are very sensitive and they are help to locate the animal where they are living. They can detect different kind of atmospheres. Just where are the lips present, there is a deep depression inside the cuticle, which is known as amphid. This amphid contain receptors, which are chemoreceptors, and help the animal to detect different types of chemical present in the atmosphere. Just near to the amphid, there is a mouth present from where they can feed. They can feed on different types of food. They are omnivores, carnivores. They can eat different types of food, which we will discuss later in the digestive system. And if we look at the posterior side, there is also a sensory receptor, which is chemoreceptor, which is known as phasmid, just near the anus. It is also a chemoreceptor, which is also sensory in function, which can detect different types of chemical environment. Just beneath the cuticle, there is a layer present, which is known as epidermis. Epidermis made the whole body of the animal. Their body is elongated and cylinder, which acts like a tube within tube. Inside this black tube, which is the main body of the animal, there is another tube, which is, you can see in the red color. This is the digestive system. So it is a tube-like, tube within tube system. If we look at the digestive system of this animal, just posterior to the mouth, there is a region of tube-like structure, which is known as buccal cavity. Mouth leads into buccal cavity, and buccal cavity leads into tubular pathway, which is known as pharynx. This portion of the digestive system is known as foregut. These animals do not have midgut, and right after the foregut, there starts hindgut. Pharynx leads into intestine, where digestion, the process of digestion and absorption takes place, and after the absorption of the food, food is ejected from the body with the help of anus or cloacal aperture from the body. So they have a very simple but little bit advanced digestive system in this animal kingdom. If we look at the nervous system, posterior to the foregut, there is a ring of neurons present, which is known as nerve ring, which is made up of ganglion, and four nerves arises from this nerve ring. One is dorsal nerve and one is ventral nerve, as you can see in the green color. So this nerve is known as dorsal nerve and this green color is known as ventral nerve. If you look at the my marker, if you suppose that this is a worm, so one nerve runs parallel to the body on the dorsal side and other runs ventral to the body, dorsal nerve and ventral nerve, while two nerves runs lateral side of the body. So there are four nerve cords which runs along the whole length of the body, which are also connected with help of commissure nerves, and they coordinate the whole body of the animal. So these animals have well developed nervous system. They also contain some bristles, amphids, and also phasmids, which helps in the reception of different types of chemicals and stimuli in the environment. The next system, which is their body contain, that is excretory system. Their excretory system is composed of some khas specialized cells, which are known as rhinati, which are present in the coelom, pseudocoelom of their body. As you know, that waste material, nitrogenous waste material, ammonia, and some other kind of material present inside the fluid of the pseudocoelom. So these cells filter waste material from the present in the fluid in the pseudocoelom, and this waste material is exported outside to the body through a pore known as excretory pore outside the body. So these animal have well developed digestive system, nervous system, and excretory system. Now let's move on to the internal structure with the cross section of the animal. So I have cut a cross section of this animal right over here with the help of a diagram. So if we cut the animals in a cross section, so this is the outer side of the body. The outermost portion of the body is known as cuticle, as we already discussed the structure of cuticle. So this area is made up of cuticle. Just beneath the cuticle, there is epidermis, as you can see right over here. So this is the epidermis, inner layer of the animal, and just under the epidermis there is tube-like structure, which is known as digestive system, as you can see in the red color. Just surrounding the digestive system, there is a cavity which is known as pseudocoelom, which is filled by fluid which provide hydrostatic skeleton to the animals. When we look at this is the dorsal nerve and this is ventral nerve, as you can see, and this area is can show the excretory system of the animals. If we look at the cross section of the animal, we can see that there are four bands of muscles present inside this animal. One muscle is right over here, one is right over here, and this is the third one and this is the fourth one. So there are four bands of muscles which are longitudinal muscles present along the whole length of the animal. These animals do not contain circular muscles. These muscles are present on the dorsolateral side, because this is the dorsal side of the animal, this is the ventral side of the animal, and these two sides are lateral side of the animals. So the muscles are present on the two muscles are present on the dorsolateral sides and two muscles are present on the ventrolateral sides. These muscles, when contract, their body produce a movement which is known as undulating movement. As you can see right over here, when these muscles contract, their body bends like this shape, and this bending can move backward toward the animal. As these bending moves backward, the animals move forward. This is known as undulating movement of this animal. This is which is a special characteristics of these animals. So far we have discussed some external and internal characteristics of this phylum Nematoda. Hopefully next lecture we are going to discuss reproductive structure and some other maintenance function of the body, and then we will discuss different life cycles of these animals belonging to this phylum. I hope it makes sense, and we'll see you in the next lecture. Until then, bye.